Camden. I'm back with another video. It's been a while since I've sat down and talked in front of the camera, so if I seem a little bit nervous, that's why. If you're new to the channel, hi, I'm Camden. I'm an American living in the south of France, teaching English, exploring the region as much as I can during these times. But if any of that interests you, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Today, we are actually talking about my job. So, yes, I'm an English teacher at a university, but I'm not a professor. I'm a lectrice d'anglais. And it sounds like lecture, but it's also not quite a lecture. A lecteur or a lectrice, if you're a woman, is a job for foreign language teachers in universities in France, and these are typically temporary jobs. Maximum 2 years, sometimes it can be a little bit longer if you're on an exchange with another university, but these are special positions. They're kind of like teaching assistants, but not quite like teaching assistants in high schools and middle schools, like in the program TAPIF, which I will talk a little bit about as well. And this video today was requested by a lovely subscriber, so thank you, Lena. If any of you ever have questions about life in France, maybe I can make a video for you. I also asked some of you on Instagram if you had any questions about my job, so hopefully I'll be able to answer them all today. And speaking of Instagram, if you're not following me, my Insta is camden.fr, camden.fr or camden.fr. And if you want to see more of daily life in France, what it's like being a teacher in France, be sure to check it out. So, as I mentioned earlier, being a lectrice is kind of like being a teaching assistant. So, you're not teaching big lecture classes, you're teaching more practical courses, mostly speaking classes. And unlike being a teaching assistant at the high school or primary level, you are the main teacher. So, you're not assisting other teachers, you are the one planning all of your classes, you are the one teaching the whole class. As a teaching assistant, you have small groups or you might work in the classroom, but you are the main teacher as a lectrice. So for the requirements, most universities ask that you have a bachelor's degree, some require a master's. If you are applying to be a maître de langue, which is a similar position to a lecteur, but to be a maître, that does require a master's degree. You also teach a little bit less, but you might teach more travaux dirigés, and I'll get into the difference between travaux pratiques and travaux dirigés a little bit later, but as a maître, you teach more TD, and you teach less hours, but you get paid more. Other requirements include being a native speaker of the language. Maybe it might not be your first language, but if you did grow up speaking it, or if it's a C2, really advanced level, then they might accept you as well. There's no age limit like TAPIF, which is great. And you don't necessarily have to be a European citizen. At my university, for example, they usually hire one British or European lectrice and one non-European lectrice like me. As a lecteur, you get paid the SMIC, which is the French minimum wage, which is about 1,500 before taxes and then 1,200 after taxes, but a little bit more every year. The SMIC increases just a little bit. I just switched positions because I thought it was a little bright with the window behind me. But I'm going to talk about the difference between TP and TD. So TP are travaux pratiques. Sorry, I have a Franglais accent here. Travaux pratiques are like tutorials. They are more speaking focused classes. Those are usually 1 hour. Mine are sometimes called English labs. But usually we just focus on speaking and sometimes listening comprehension. So I will pick a random topic or a current event to talk about. We'll go over some vocabulary, maybe watch a little video or listen to a short clip so they can get that oral comprehension, discuss whatever we just listened or watched. And then we will maybe even have more discussions, or I'll have the students work together in groups and do some role play, create their own dialogue, or present a little speech about that topic. My TD are travaux dirigés, and as a lectrice, you're not really, you can't really teach a lot of these classes. Most of your classes are supposed to be TP, but travaux dirigés are a little bit longer classes, they're a little bit more involved, so In addition to speaking, you can focus on writing and other skills. Some examples of the TD that I've taught are English for non-specialists, so I teach English classes for history and geography students as well. And then I also teach some for the English department, like pratique de la langue and pratique orale. In pratique de la langue, in that class, I taught some phonology, I taught speaking practice, we looked at the IPA, did lots of speaking exercises, so a little bit more involved than just conversation classes. So my schedule changes from semester to semester. Luckily at my school they gave us the Fridays off, but that's not always the case for lecture all around France. It depends on your university. I can see if I can insert one of my past schedules here just to give you an idea, but I usually teach about 3 to 5 classes a day. I don't always teach every day. Some days, like this semester, Tuesdays, I just teach in the afternoon, which is pretty nice, so I don't have to be at the university all the time. I can just come for my classes. If I want to plan in the office, I can, or I can plan from home. It is nice having a lot of school breaks, especially in France. Teaching, I love this job, but it can be kind of draining sometimes. It's a lot of work during the weeks where you are teaching, so it is really nice to have frequent holiday breaks. My university, I do have to plan all the content, and from speaking with other lecteurs in France, that is typically what you usually do. This is really awesome because you have a lot of freedom, you can share your own culture, you can talk about your interests, you can see what the students are interested in. At the same time, if you are not comfortable lesson planning, this can be kind of hard. Sorry, so my Sony camera was overheating, so I just switched to my iPhone, so that's why the video might look different again. Anyway, as I was saying, I do have to plan all the content for my classes, but I really enjoy that because it gives me a lot of freedom to be creative. But again, if you are someone who is kind of new to teaching, that might be a little bit difficult. However, I have used some lessons passed down for me from the previous lectrice. There's also lots of great ESL websites where you can get free lessons if you're running out of ideas. Again, there are no specific requirements when it comes to teaching certifications to be a lecteur, but if you go do a TEFL program or maybe a CELTA, I personally have a master's in education, I studied to become a teacher. This can definitely help you prepare to teach, but they are not necessary if you don't want to become a teacher after being a lecteur. So the French grading system is a lot different than the one in the US. In the US, we have grades out of 100, and I talked about this in my French versus American schools video. In France, the grades are out of 20. Also, the average in France is 10 out of 20, which is 50%. In the US, the average is about 75%. So it was hard to adjust to that. One professor I worked with explained it to me, and that really helped. I also use rubrics to help me. As a lectrice, I tend to want to give everyone a really good grade just because I know speaking can be hard sometimes. But when I use a rubric where I clearly detail the skills I'm looking for, maybe I'll pop another example here to show you, but having a rubric really helps me to stay fair in my grading. So my students are not that much older than me. I teach university students, so they are 18 to in their early 20s, and I'm 25, so that's not a big age difference. Luckily, since they are adults, I don't have to worry too much about classroom management. Sometimes they can be a little chatty, so if they are being disrespectful, I can tell them to leave the classroom. Now, but this is really cool because I get to kind of be a fun teacher. I get to connect with them, and they might open up to me a little bit more, which I think is important when you're speaking because you want to be able to connect and relate to that person. But sometimes I do get mistaken for a student because I do look pretty young. So this really depends, and this is just my experience, my observations working in French schools over the past few years. I've been a teaching assistant in middle and high schools, I've volunteered in elementary schools as well, and now I work in a university.
So they do start learning English earlier than we do in the US. In elementary school, maybe you'll have like, I'm not sure how many hours they have, but it's not too frequent. Maybe a language assistant might come in and teach them some songs, some vocabulary, but they don't really start having structured classes until middle school, which is still earlier than us in the US, where we don't start learning until high school. However, France is known for not having a strong English level like some other countries in Europe, like Germany does. Most of my students studying English as their major, they have a pretty advanced level, but the non-specialists, that can definitely be very mixed. Hi, I'm in another room again because I had a class. This is my classroom. Okay, this is not the classroom I teach in all the time. It's just for one of my classes because it is a little bit bigger. It's just about 30 people. This is way more space. Normally my classes range between like, my smallest class is about 5 people and my largest is about 30, but it can be different. My average class size is around 20 students, but we're actually doing co-modal, which is half online, half in person. So some of my classes I teach all in person right now. Some are, I have one that's fully in person and then I have two that are co-modal. So half of the students will attend in person and then the other half will attend on Zoom. So as I am teaching in person, I'm also talking to my laptop on Zoom. So that's one difficult thing adapting this year. Last year, actually, around this time is when the first lockdown happened in France and I had to start teaching all of my classes online. So it's been a long ride since then, but I definitely prefer teaching in person.
Hi everybody, it's the next day. That's Cerbère in the background, if anyone's wondering. I'm just in my home office now. And the next question is, how did I get this job? And is it the kind of work I had in mind when I was a student? So I'll tell you a little bit about my studies and how I got here. So I originally did a bachelor's degree in French and I studied to become a French teacher. I did a Master of Arts in Teaching right after that. And instead of going straight into teaching, I wanted to spend some time in France first. And I did the TAPIF program. I didn't study abroad before, so I wasn't quite ready yet in undergrad. I did a short summer program, but I spent 7 months abroad with TAPIF, and then I wanted to improve my French even more. So I did another master's in French this time with Middlebury College. And luckily with TAPIF, I was able to get a generous scholarship that really helped fund my year in Paris. And then after living in Paris, I still really enjoyed living in France and I didn't want to leave. I wanted to keep working here. So I was looking for ways to stay in France. And through Middlebury, sometimes they will tell you about some job opportunities because they have a little bit of a network there. And one of the positions I applied for was électrice at a school in the south of Paris, an engineering school. And then I learned that, hey, this is not just at this one school, this is a position throughout all of France. So I started looking for forums. I read some other blog posts from some other bloggers, which I'll link below as well, and found out, hey, universities all over France have these lectrices and lecteurs jobs. So I found a website that I will link below where they have tons of postings for lecteur jobs. But you can also search for specific universities if there's a specific university you'd like to work for. Or if you want to work in a specific city, you can just type université, maybe like Lyon, and then lecteur d'anglais, and then also the year, so the next school year that you'd want to teach. And usually these posts start appearing in late February at the earliest. Most appear in April, March as well, March through April, and then sometimes you might see in May and June, but it's mostly in the spring when universities start to post these job opportunities. So on these job postings, they usually ask you to send a dossier with some documents, including a CV and a cover letter or lettre de motivation in French. And usually they might ask you to write them in French or English, depending on the department, but it's a good idea to have CV and motivation letters in both languages, just in case. Some might ask for your diplomas, some might ask you to send translated copies of the diploma as well. Others might ask for recommendation letters, things like that. So I applied to maybe 10 positions all around France. So some of the universities might email you back telling you that they got your email. Others might not get any response from. Some I got some rejections right away because I already filled the post. I got some no replies. I also got 3 interviews. 2 of my 3 interviews were in person, and these 2 were for University UT. They were engineering schools and technical schools outside of Paris in the suburbs, and I didn't get those jobs. They actually called me and told me that I ranked 3rd or 4th in some of them. So that's interesting that they tell you your rank. And I think they usually pick about 5 people to interview out of all the applications that they get. My 3rd interview was for this random little school in a city I had never really heard of in the south of France, but I sent my CV in anyway, and I had a Skype interview with them, and a few hours later that same day, they called me and they told me I was their first choice, and they gave me the weekend to think things over before I decided. And I had gotten another job offer for a teaching assistant in a Montessori school in Paris, which I was excited about because I loved Paris, I wanted to stay there, and I thought the Montessori system was really interesting. However, I didn't really want to be an assistant after my years of schooling. I had a teaching license. I was ready to get in the classroom and be the main teacher. So even though I was sad to leave Paris, I was looking forward to moving to the south of France, seeing something new, and also having a more challenging job. And in February last year, the department was pleased with how I was doing, so they asked me to stay for a second year. And usually the schools want their lecturer to stay for at least 2 years because that's how long the contract can be, and it's, you know, easier just to keep the same person another year. And so that's something that they might ask you in your interview if you'd want to stay for 2 years.
Hi, just jumping back in here real quick because I realized I forgot to talk a little bit more in depth about the contracts. So they are 1 year long, they are fixed term contracts, CDD, and they can be renewed 1 year. Again, unless you're doing an exchange with a university, then you might have maybe 3 years, but 1 year, and then renewable up to 2 years. And you get paid all throughout the 12 months of your contract. And unfortunately, you cannot renew in another school. So if you are a lecteur or lectrice in one university, you cannot get hired as a lecteur in another one, which I know is kind of frustrating, but that's how life is sometimes, especially in France with all their administrative rules. I'm not sure if you can be a maître de langue after being a lecteur for 2 years. That's a little unclear, and I think each university might interpret that law a little bit differently.
Also, in the interview, I might give you some ideas of the types of questions they ask. So they'll usually ask you to present yourself. That's probably one of the first questions they'll ask. And most interviews are a mix of French and English, at least that had been my experience. So you might want to have an intermediate level of French at least, just because even though you'll be speaking English most of the time, especially when you're teaching, you will need some French to deal with administrative things, talk to other faculty members, and help students whose English might not be super advanced. And since I am not European, I'm American, the university was able to sponsor my visa. So lecture jobs are awesome if you're not European and you need a visa, because they usually are able to sponsor visas. And I have a blog article as well as an interesting visa story on this YouTube channel if you want to check those out. And I explain the process of how I got my visa to work here. Overall, I've had a pretty positive experience working as a lectrice d'anglais. Again, it can vary from university to university and from person to person, and this is just my experience, but I've really enjoyed it despite some of the challenges, like Teaching online, dealing with bigger classes, adjusting to the French grading system, and having a lot of classes to teach sometimes. But I think it was a really rewarding experience. I'm sad to leave, but I'm also excited for the next chapter in my life. Contract is ending this summer. What am I doing next? What are my plans? And to be honest, I'm not quite sure yet. And it really scares me because I've had a plan ever since I finished my first master's. I was doing the TAPIF program, then I was doing a master's in French, and then I got my lectrice job. And right now I'm looking for international schools, bilingual schools in France. Just because I already have a master's and a teaching license, it's kind of different in France. If you want to work at a school in the public schools in France, you actually have to be European. But you can take the concours, the CAPES CAFEP, and work in the Catholic private schools in France as a non-European. There's a master's called the MEF, M-E-E-F, if anyone's interested in getting teacher training in France. Or you can work at an independent school and be hired through them. And I've known a few other Americans who have gotten jobs at international schools. So I know it's not impossible, but it's very rare and hard to get them to sponsor your visa. So I'm currently looking for international bilingual schools, but I have backup plans. I am considering becoming a freelance teacher as well and applying for the profession libérale entrepreneur visa. And what else? I applied to TAPIF again since I technically only did it 1 year, and I could do primary teaching just as something to change, but I'm looking for something a little bit more full-time. And what else could I do? I'm not sure. I don't really want to go back to school right now. I'm not interested in doing a PhD at the moment. I want to continue working, and I'm also open to other jobs. I like the tourism industry. You know, I have a travel blog, but again, I think you might have to have a degree in tourism to work in that industry in France. I'm not sure though. Education management could be interesting, or even education technology. I know a lot of other teachers are moving to education technology since that's a growing field and they're getting teacher burnout. So I will keep you updated on that next adventure when I find out what's happening. Oh, and if I have to move back to the US, I would become a French teacher. I have a French teaching license, I studied French, and that's what I think I would enjoy doing. But for now, I really want to stay in France. So hopefully I was able to answer all of your questions, and if I forgot anything or if there's something else you're curious about, please leave me a comment. And if you've made it this far in the video, leave a little apple emoji in the comments to let me know you've been a good student and you've been paying attention this whole lecture. Anyway, that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Again, please be sure to subscribe if you want to learn more about life in France or teaching in France. And I'll see you next time. À la prochaine.